Hello everyone. So you've got yourself a shiny new FA-18 Hornet for DCS World. Now you are wondering, how do I get started? Well, you've come to the right place. I'll be going over the set of key bindings you need to know before you jump into the cockpit. So let's get started. So the first thing we're going to look at is the axis assign page in the options and controls menu. We're going to make sure we're on the FA-18C sim, and we're going to go down here to axis assign. We're going to scroll down until we see pitch, and we're going to assign this to the Y axis on our joystick, which will control the nose of the plane up and down. We'll click on there after it's bound and go axis tune. We'll set a dead zone of 4, because when you try to engage the autopilot and your stick isn't straight, the autopilot won't engage. So with this little bit of a dead zone, you get a little bit more leeway when engaging the autopilot. I have set the curve to 15. We come down to roll. Bound to the X axis on the joystick, so this is banking left and right. I've set a dead zone at 4 for the autopilot reason, same as the pitch, and a curve of 15. I have a twist joystick, so I have my rudder set to the twist. If you have rudder pedals, you want to bind that to the rudder, or your pedal, sorry. I have no dead zone on this, and a curve of 10. Now we have radar elevation control. So with this, I can adjust the height of my scan with the attack radar. And when I'm using the FLIR targeting pod, I can use this as the optical zoom. I just have it set to a slider switch on my throttle. On my throttle, I also have a joystick, or a little thumbstick like you would see on like a PlayStation or Xbox controller. Now I have it bound to the throttle designator controller on the horizontal axis and the vertical axis. So with this, when you're on the attack radar, you want to move the cursor around to hover over targets, and if you're using the FLIR targeting pod, you can move the camera with this. So I've bound it to the little thumbstick on the throttle. So for thrust, you can bind both engines to one axis, or if you have a split throttle, you can bind each engine to its own axis. So that's it for the axis, and now we'll go on to the other controls. So we're going to come back to the controls page, make sure we're on the FA-18C sim page again. And we're going to scroll down until we get to the arresting hook. So when you're wanting to land on a carrier, you'll need to put the hook down to hook onto the cable on the deck. So you can bind this to a key, or you can use H on the keyboard. And come down to battery switch. Now you can either just click it in the cockpit, or you can have it bound to a switch. I have it bound to a little switch here. The uncage button, very important. So you can bind this to a button on your throttle, or you can use C on the keyboard. Canopy open and close, you can manually click the switch in the cockpit, or you can push a button on your throttle or joystick. And keep on coming down. This one's important. It's the communications menu on the FA-18C. I didn't bind it, but I'm going to bind it right now. So I'm going to bind it to a button on my throttle. I'm going to want it on button 77. So this will open the little F10 menu or communications menu in the top right, and you can select ground, crew, flight, etc. for easy communications. So you can set a button for the dispenser switch, or you can click it in the cockpit. Now you can have dispense switch forward and backward. So this will dispense the chaff and flare. So when you have your set up your chaff and flare program in the EW page on the FA-18, it'll correspond to which direction you're pushing the dispenser switch. We got eject. You want to eject if you're going to crash, or if you got a missile incoming you're not going to avoid and you want to save your pilot. Make sure this is bound. As you can note, you'll need to hit this button 3 times before you eject. And keep on coming down. FCS reset button. Now you can look to your bottom left and you can push the button. Or if you have a spare button on your throttle or joystick, you can set that to a key. Formation lights. I have a knob where I can turn them up and down. You don't have to have these. It's just for ease of access. So the trigger for shooting your gun, you want to bind it to your joystick on the trigger button. Keyboard command is spacebar. Keep on coming down. So we got landing gear up and down. You can bind this to a switch on your throttle or joystick if you have room. Or alternatively, you can just hit the G key and that'll act as the up and down. So optional, I have a LTD/R switch to cycle between on and off. So when I want to use my FLIR targeting pod to paint a target with the laser, I have to flick this switch up. I have a master switch arm button. You can also use just the mouse in the cockpit to click it up. Same with safe. Anti-air mode, anti-ground mode. I have bound to a button on my throttle. Now you can just select it in the cockpit. Position lights, same as the formation lights, on a different knob. Optional. The RAID FLIR FOV select. So this will, when you push this button, when you're using your FLIR targeting pod, you can zoom in and out with the wide and narrow view. So your weapon select. I have a little hat on my, where my thumb sits on the joystick. So I have them set to the 4 positions for AMRAAM, Gun, Sidewinder, and Sparrow. This is a key one. So sensor control switch. So this is where you're going to put the diamond on the screen. So where you're going to take the information from. So if you want to control the right screen, you're going to want to push sensor control switch right. And you'll operate off of the right screen. If you want to work off the HUD, you'll push forward and it'll put it on there. And also if you wanted to use your helmet mounted sight, you can push up and it'll go onto the helmet sight. So make sure all these are bound with the depress button. Speed brake. I have a bound on my throttle, so I can extend the speed brake and retract it. You want to make sure those are bound. So this is to set your throttle from idle or from off to idle. You want to make note of this command right alt home if you don't have a switch for it on your throttle or joystick. Right alt and end will turn from idle to off. Same with the other throttle. You want right shift home and right shift end. You'll also want to bind the throttle designator controller G press button. So I have the throttle designator controller up, down, left, right bound in the axis screen, but if you don't have a POV hat, you can bind it to a button on your joystick here. Toggle goggles. So when you want to use your night vision goggles, you want to push a button, it's bound to right shift H, or you can bind it to a button on your keyboard or throttle. Trimmer switch. So this is when you want to trim out your aircraft. You want to put your left wing down. I hit the trim left. Make sure these four options are bound. So you want to bind the undesignate nose wheel steer switch. So this will turn your nose wheel steering on high if you're on the ground, so you can move in a tighter spot, or you can undesignate the target. Thank you for watching my tutorial on the keybinds you need to know to fly the FA-18C Hornet in DCS World. Again, thank you for watching, and if you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe button. Let me know in the comments if there are any important keybinds I missed, or if there is a certain topic you would like me to cover in future videos. This is AFTY86 signing off, and we'll see you in the skies.